What you are looking at are a series of off-road vehicles traversing one of the largest young lava fields on the planet. Located in Ethiopia, you might be surprised to learn that these vehicles are currently below sea level. Here, two tectonic plates are spreading apart, leading to a rift valley which magma has frequently intruded and erupted into, as is the case at the Erta Ale Shield volcano right now. Erta Ale represents one of the 51 volcanoes which are currently erupting around the planet, which is two more than were erupting last week. With this being said, here are this week's major volcano-related news stories. In Indonesia, the alert level was raised at the erupting Marapi volcano, with an explosion soon after throwing a boulder of lava approximately a kilometer into the air. Also in Indonesia, Lewotobi's eruption rapidly intensified, leading to the evacuations of nearby residents. And, in what is this week's top story, the alert level of Iceland's Grimsvotn volcano was raised as a fairly sizable glacial flood known as a jökulhlaup began. Since September of 2023, the number of earthquakes of the Grimsvotn volcano remained low, but also elevated above normal background levels. This seemingly culminated in a swarm of 6 magnitude 1 range earthquakes on January 4th, causing Grimsvotn's alert level to be temporarily raised to yellow. At the same time, I noticed some ground tremor on the tremor charts, which happened to be caused by the subglacial movement of water. Over the next several days, this water began flowing towards the south, beginning what is known as a jökulhlaup. Historically speaking, not only have some jökulhlaups been caused by shallow magma being present, but some jökulhlaups not created by magma relieved so much stress on the overlying crust that it actually caused an eruption to occur. Thus, a low double-digit percentage of jökulhlaups from Grimsvotn occur alongside a volcanic eruption. While Grimsvotn's alert level was subsequently lowered back to green on January 5th, it was raised back to yellow on the 11th as an expected 1,000 cubic meter per second flood began to enter Giga Fishta River. This jökulhlaup is considered to be moderate in size, as larger jökulhlaups associated with eruptions have been as large as 50,000 cubic meters per second. While this could technically still cause an eruption, in my opinion, this flood was caused by an increase in fumarole-related temperatures, with overall data not suggesting an imminent eruption. Meanwhile, in Indonesia, the nature of the ongoing eruption from Sumatra's Mount Merapi has changed. From the onset of its latest eruption, which began with deadly consequences on December 3rd, ongoing until January 6th, the majority of its eruptive activity was phreatic. In other words, not directly involving magma, but instead water heated by magma, essentially creating powerful steam explosions. Well, earlier this week, an orange glow began emanating from Merapi's summit crater. This occurred as shallow magma continued creeping up its magma conduit, indicating a switch from a primarily phreatic to magmatic eruption. As a result, on January 9th, Merapi's alert level was raised from 2 to 3, occurring alongside an expansion of its exclusion zone from 3 kilometers in all directions to 4.5 kilometers in all directions. 66 people were evacuated as they lived in the newly expanded zone. This change was soon proven as warranted as Merapi ejected several boulder-sized blocks of lava 950 meters into the air in powerful volcanic explosions, which could hurl superheated rock multiple kilometers distant. Meanwhile, on the island of Flores in Indonesia, the eruption of the Lewotobi volcano greatly intensified. As a result, the erupting Laki-Laki cone became the first volcano in 2 years within Indonesia to be placed at the maximum alert level, an alert level of red. This has it joining a list that includes some fairly dangerous eruptions which have occurred since 2010. This change was made as during a 24-hour period, almost every metric sensors measured rapidly spiked. What was beforehand a weekly erupting series of events subsequently turned into a major eruption producing repeated pyroclastic flows which traveled 2 kilometers to the east and north. The increased level of gas emissions coincided with the arrival of magma which soon erupted to the north, spilling down Laki-Laki slopes and creating lava avalanches. This basaltic andesite lava flow is the first to have occurred from Laki-Laki since 1907 and has already advanced 3 kilometers to the east-northeast. These lava flows are still advancing, and also due to the potential for longer-reaching pyroclastic flows to occur, Lewotobi's exclusion zone was expanded twice, now being a minimum of 4 to 5 kilometers in all directions. Here is a quick list of all the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing varying degrees of unrest which are not currently erupting as of January 13th of 2024. As a final note, I would like to thank my new YouTube member, Wilco Faber, for supporting this channel.